Reduce rational expressions. So like we were talking about in the last video, to reduce fractions, we divide out common factors. So that means, in order to see what our factors are, we're going to have to first factor. So let's go ahead and take a look at a couple of examples. So example one here, I've got 2x squared plus 5x minus 3, divided by 2x squared minus 5x plus 2. So in this case, when I go to factor the top, I know that I need to get 2x squared, so I'll say that's going to be 2x times x. Then somehow I need to get this negative 3, so I'll have to have a 3 and a 1. And somehow it needs to add up to that 5 in the middle. So I'm going to try a 3 right here, 1 right here. So then if I did plus, minus, so then I'd be coming up with 3x and negative 2x. Ooh, that's only going to give me 1x in the middle, so that's not going to work. So here we go back to that guess and check thing. So it's looking like I actually want to put some of these in different places. So I'm going to put my 3 over here and my 1 over here. So now I should get minus x and plus 6x. And that will give me that plus 5x in the middle. There we go, much better. Okay, and then factoring for the bottom. Again, I'm going to want to have 2x and x. And now I want to multiply to this positive 2. So I'm going to have a 1 and a 2. But it needs to add up to this negative in the middle. So I'm going to try putting some negative signs in, see if that'll give me enough negative numbers to give me the negative in the middle. So this is negative x, and this is minus 4x. So that'll definitely add up to my negative 5x in the middle. Cool. So that looks like we've now successfully factored. So now in order to divide out our factors, we have to see which ones match that we'll divide out. So it looks to me like this one is exactly the same as this one. Same coefficients, same numbers, same signs. So these ones will now completely divide out. And that means that our final answer right here is going to be x plus 3 over x minus 2. Our simplified rational expression. Okay, now let's go ahead and take a look at example 2. So, in example 2, I've got 9x squared minus 30x plus 25. It looks to me like I've got perfect square right here, perfect square right here. So, let's see, what would my square roots be on each side? So on this side, my square root would be 3x. And on this side, my square root would be 5. If I multiplied those together to get my 2ab, 2 times 3x times 5 would give me 30x, exactly what I've got in the middle. So it looks like the top I'm going to be able to factor using our perfect squares rule. So that's going to be 3x minus 5 times 3x minus 5. And then on the bottom, I've also got a perfect square in my first term, perfect square in my last term, but here I've only got two terms, and I've got this minus sign in the middle. So this is going to be a difference of squares. So for my difference of squares, I want to take the square root, which turns out is exactly the same thing as it was before. Very convenient. So now I'll have 3x plus 5 and 3x minus 5. Okay, so again, we want to divide out anything that completely matches. These two completely match. So then our final answer is going to be this rational expression right here, successfully reduced.